Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is the first Friday of September. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The designs of his heart are from age to age, to rescue their souls from death, and to keep them alive in famine.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we offer this Mass for the first Friday of September, also the first day of the month, no? Of course, for many, we begin the holiday season. No? But let us pray to the Sacred Heart of our Lord that He may continue to let us experience His love and mercy for us, and that He may also set our hearts on fire for love, out of love for Him and our neighbor. My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that, as you receive from us how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. This is the will of God, your holiness, that you refrain from immorality, that each of you know how to acquire a wife for himself in holiness and honor, not in lustful passion, as do the Gentiles who do not know God, not to take advantage of or exploit a brother or sister in this matter. For the Lord is an avenger in all these things. As we told you before and solemnly affirmed, for God did not call us to impurity, but to holiness. Therefore, whoever disregards this, disregards not a human being, but God, who also gives his Holy Spirit to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
The Lord is King. Let the earth rejoice. Let the many isles be glad. Justice and judgment are the foundation of his throne.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his justice, and all peoples see his glory.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
The Lord loves those who hate evil. He guards the lives of his faithful ones. From the hand of the wicked, he delivers them.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Light dawns for the just, and gladness for the upright of heart. Be glad in the Lord, you just, and give thanks to his holy name.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just.
Alleluia, alleluia. Be vigilant at all times and pray, that you may have the strength to stand before the Son of Man. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them. But the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight there was a cry, "Behold the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish one said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and for you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah, today I'd like to invite you to reflect on 3 points. No, of course, this is a very familiar parable, no, about the wise virgin. So it's a parable of about the kingdom, no, about the coming of Christ, no. So the first one is, of course, to reflect on vigilance, no, to be ready, our readiness, no. And then the second is, I think part of that vigilance, if not a great part really of that vigilance and readiness, is always living a life of integrity and consistency, no. And then the third and last point is the discipline that comes again with living a life of integrity and consistency, no. I think it's very important. It's almost like it is the discipline that operationalizes the consistency and integrity, no. So take a look at the 3 points about our readiness, no. Our readiness, yes, for the coming of Christ, no. Our readiness for death, but also our readiness in the day to day, to experience or to feel or to see the presence of Christ, no, in our day-to-day experiences. As we often say, no, to recognize the extraordinary presence of God in our ordinary moments in the day-to-day. And here you have that whole point of vigilance and readiness, no. How can one be vigilant? How can one be ready? I guess it is always a certain consistency, no. It's very related to that second point, no, of living a life of consistency and integrity, no. And remember what I shared with you, what supposedly was John Berkman's, no, when he was asked, "What will you do if you know you're going to die soon?" No, and then supposedly his answer, "I will do what I am doing," no, adjek pod adjis, no. And for me, that simple response really tells us, no, that at any given time, someone who says, "Well, if you're going to die soon, what will you do? I will continue to do what I am doing," that is most certainly a life of integrity and a life of consistency, no. That one does not need to scramble and do good things, no, knowing that, you know, they have very few days left, so to speak, no. I think precisely, you know, it is just continuing what one is doing in the day-to-day that accounts for integrity and consistency. And there is no greater grace and way to prepare, no, than for one to live that way in the day-to-day, no. So again, that readiness, that vigilance, and a readiness and vigilance that comes from our integrity and consistency in the day-to-day. And as we said, no, the third point is having that self-discipline, no. Having the self-discipline to constantly do the little things in the day-to-day. It's not one day we're okay, the other day, no, we're time out, no. While it is good to have breaks and to take some rest, no, I think that the discipline of doing the little things in the day-to-day is very, very important, no. And of course, for those of you who are familiar, no, with sports, no, it is precisely in the day-to-day practice, in doing the drills, in doing the warm-up exercises to avoid injuries, and doing all the little drills, no, and really studying the plays, no. All of these little acts of discipline and little acts of consistency, again, no, will really make us ready, no. So siguro ngayon, pag nilaya natin to, no, yun yung inaanyayahan tayo ng ating ebanghelyo ngayong araw, na laging maging handa, no. laging maging mapagmatyag at maging handa. Dahil sapagkat ang Diyos ay sabi nga, di ba, yung sa kanyang muling pagbabalik, at meron din, di ba, yung pagdating ng ating kamatayan kung saan tayo aanyayahan ng Panginoon na umuwi na sa kanya. Pero meron din yung mga ano, no, yung makita ang presensya niya sa araw-araw, no. Na handa tayo, no, na mulat tayo at na mapagmatyag tayo. Yun yung unang punto, no. At yung pangalawang punto, nakaugnay nitong pagiging handa at mapagmatyag, paano ba tayo magiging handa, no? Ang mabuhay ng isang buhay na may integridad at merong katapatan, may pagkapare-pareho, yun yung consistency, no, ng ating pamumuhay sa araw-araw. At sabi nga, di ba, ni St. John Berkman, sabi niya, tinanong siya, anong gagawin mo kung alam mong mamamatay ka na? Sabi niya, gagawin ko pa rin kung anong ginagawa ko ngayon. Yun ang integridad, ano? At yun ang masasabi natin, pagkakapare-pareho, ang consistency ng ating pagsasabuhay, ng ating pang-araw-araw na gawain, na alam natin dahil tapat tayo sa ating relasyon sa Panginoon, tapat tayo sa ating misyon, kaya patuloy lang natin gagawin kung ano yung nakasanayan natin na ginagawa sa araw-araw, no? At mahalaga rin yun kasi doon mo makikita yung disiplina, no? Na ang disiplina ng pagsasabuhay ng ating biyaya, ng ating bukasyon, ng ating misyon sa araw-araw, yun ang talagang maghahanda sa atin, no? Sa maliit man o malaking bagay, binubuhay natin, ano, ang ating bukasyon at ang ating misyon, no? Na sa lahat ng bagay ay patuloy tayong may disiplina, no, sa araw-araw, no? Siguro maganda na pag nilaya natin ito at tanungin natin ang ating sarili, talaga tayo ba ay handa, no? Kung tayo ay siguro hindi naman kamatayan, ano, kung ating makikita ang Diyos sa araw-araw, tayo ba ay handa, tayo ba ay may disiplina na malaman niya na nandun ang presensya ng Diyos. So today let us pray for that. Let us pray that yes, we may be vigilant and ready, that remember it is through the integrity and the consistency of our day-to-day living and the discipline to live out consistently and very very ano, very very much with great integrity our relationship with Christ, that is what will always make us ready to see His presence. Remember, finding God in all things, in the ordinary moments of our day-to-day life, to be able to encounter Christ. The gospel message reminds us to be wise and vigilant as we wait for the coming of the Lord Jesus. Let us pray for the world He has redeemed.
That the church may read the signs of the times and constantly remind God's people of the eternal dimension of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That young people may remain hopeful and enthusiastic about life. May their idealism aid them in pursuing great things in life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those discouraged and wounded by life may not grow bitter, but draw fresh strength and hope from Christ, who promised us His presence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, Father of mercies, who because of the great love with which you loved us with untold goodness, gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with Him, we may offer you worthy homage through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, He gave Himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from His pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacraments, so that won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offered their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat. And again, please join us for Proyecto Pilipino this weekend. The episode is really very nice. It's about the food stamps program of the DSWD and how to combat hunger, no, and of course malnutrition and eventually also poverty, no. So please join us for that. It's available in the Conscience Collective YouTube channel. It's going to be shown in Jeepney TV and Sky Cable 155 and 955 this weekend. So please join us, and really a really very good episode, no, on in Proyecto Pilipino on the food stamps program of the DSWD. And of course, join us also for Journeys of Hope. Maraming pong salamat. Have a good weekend ahead. And let's again pray to the Sacred Heart of our Lord. Thank you po.
Lindol. Pagputok ng bulkan. Bagyo.
Nakunan po ng video ng habang tinatangay.
Baha. Malakas din ang agos ng tubig niyan eh. Madadala ka talaga.
Instincts nga na kapag siguro may nangangailangan ng tulong.
Lahat ng ito, madalas natin maranasan. At lahat ng ito, kailangan nating sama-samang lampasan.
Sa alay para sa katugunan sa kalamidad, pinapatatag at pinapalakas ng Caritas Philippines ang kakayanan ng mga social action centers sa paghanda at pagtugon sa kalamidad at sa mga emergency situation. Ginagabayan natin sila para makarecover at sa rehabilitation doon sa kanilang community.
Relief packages, wash or water sanitation and hygiene, shelter, livelihood, community formation, capacity building activities. Ito ang mga tulong na ibinigay ng Alay Kapwa.
Itong nakaraang taon, mahigit kumulang sa 200 communities na o 650,000 families o 3.2 million individuals na ang ating natulungan. Sa inyong patuloy na suporta, patuloy din ang Caritas Philippines na makatulong sa marami pang komunidad.
Kapit-bisig sa anumang trahedya.
Ito ang ating Alay Kapwa. Alay Kapwa.